नाम से जानते हैं, गाय मतलब इंग्लिश वाला गाय। तो बुकलेट मेक इंडिया रीड इज फ्रीली अवेलेबल ऑन प्ले स्टोर एंड एप्पल स्टोर। बट ऑफ कोर्स आई डोंट स्टैंड फॉर बुकलेट ऐप, आई स्टैंड फॉर द हायर पर्पज ऑफ रीडिंग हैबिट। आई डोंट केयर whether you install booklet app or not, I'm not here to promote booklet app, but to make you effective readers. So as the mission grew, people started inviting me at various seminars, international conferences to inspire and address the crowd about my reading passion. And typical questions started popping up from the crowd. You know, Amrut, I'm a slow reader. Amrut, I don't remember what I read. How to implement the ideas that I've read. I don't get time to read books. No, I leave books half read and then I feel guilty about it. So I could easily relate with these problems because even I was struggling with the same problems a few years ago. And I started experimenting a lot with my reading life. That's my favorite hobby, to experiment a lot with books and reading habit. And finally, I identified those 7 vital habits which will promise that books will never go out of your life. In fact, they will become an integral part of your daily routine. And you don't have to take out separate time for books. That's the biggest, you know, people have a misconception that we should have a lot of time to read books. Just when the lockdown was declared by Narendra Modi, everybody, you know, all these people started calling me, WhatsApp messages. Amrut, now make a video and appeal to all your 16 lakh people that come on now, start reading. You have a lot of time, you are locked down. I did not make that video because I don't want to give a false message that you have to have a lot of time to read books. But the lockdown khatam hone ke baad wapas bhul jayenge kya books ko? So that's not the case. And so finally, those experiments manifested into a book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Readers, not written by Stephen Covey. He is my favorite author. So as a tribute to him, I adopted his title. So I replaced the word people with readers. So I'm going to discuss these 7 habits with you. Yeah. The first habit. Many of us have the guilt of leaving books half read. But one gentleman proudly said, if I get what I want, I even don't even bother to complete the book. I really like that approach. That's what exactly habit number one talks about. The name of first habit is actually a non-habit, if I say. It's called, don't take reading too seriously. Yes, I am saying this, booklet guy who has read thousands of books. What do I mean by this? If something is important to you, don't make it special. Make it casual. Because habits are casual. Yeah, you take any habit which you do on a daily basis, which are not even part of your day to-do list, yet you end up doing them. Can you name a few of them? Watching TV. Yeah. Chit-chatting or chatting on WhatsApp. Gossiping, listening to music. They are so casual that we don't even consider them as an activity. And hence, they are an integral part of our daily routine. Okay, so something is casual becomes habitual, and something is habitual is always casual. That's a virtuous circle. But reading mein hum kya karte hai? We take it so seriously. Amrut, I start reading the book with a lot of enthusiasm from page number 1. But by the time I reach page number 20 na, sab tai-tai phus, you know, wo dost ne bola, bahut achha book hai, par mujhe maza nahi aa raha, aisa kyun? Yeah? Then I counter question them. So do you say when you watch TV, a serial, and you don't like it, you just change the channel. Do you say, oh, I watched that Thugs of Hindustan movie and then left it in the interval, I have insulted Aamir Khan. Yeah? I'm a bad movie watcher. Aisa bolte kya? No, why? Because we transfer the onus to keep us entertained to the director, to the artist. Yeah, they fail to keep us entertained and hence, it's not my problem, it is their problem. But when it comes to books, no, it is all our fault. Yeah. No, it is not all your fault. It is also the responsibility of the author to keep you engaged, to keep you hooked, right? Because writing a book is also an art. It is not everybody's cup of tea. Yeah, see, I'm not here to insult the authors. My intention is to remove the guilt from your heads that there is nothing called good reader and bad reader. There is only reader and non-reader. That's all. Right? So when I started transferring the onus to the author, I did not feel guilty about it anymore. And I proudly say that, yes, I have left hundreds of books half read. But then, even if I quit the book, I don't quit reading. I started replacing books with pages. Even if I have read 10 pages, that's fine. Kuch toh sikhne ko milega. And after reading 10, 20 pages, if at all I'm losing interest, I'm not feeling like going ahead, maybe the whole objective of the book was to teach you what kind of books you should not read. Wo toh purpose solve ho gaya. Right? So nothing is waste of time. Yeah. So I usually read first 10 pages. So there is an old adage which goes, don't judge the book by its cover. Yes, I fully agree. We should not judge the book by its cover, but judge it after reading 10 pages. Yeah. So after reading 10 pages, I decide whether I should read the rest of the 190 pages. Yeah. So don't take reading too seriously. I can give one more analogy to convince you. Suppose there is a seminar, you are part of the audience, and the speaker comes, starts speaking at the podium, but he's boring, he's lacking the charisma, he's wandering off the topic, he's also not even possessing the expert domain knowledge on which he's talking, paka raha hai. What will you say as part of the audience? Arey yaar, isko kisne laya? Kitna paka raha hai? I hope you will not say this about me. And either you will take out your mobile, and your hands will start dancing on the screen, or you will find an opportunity or pasli gali se nikal jaoge, right? But when the same speaker writes a book and it comes on your hand, you have to read word to word. Are you getting my point? Same person, same message, perhaps the same message, because he's going to write the same thing what he's speaking at the seminar. Yes or no? At least not opposite. Same person when the medium changes. Why? Are you getting my point? Yeah? Agar bhashan dene wala achha nahi hai, bhashan de raha hai, to aap taali nahi bajaoge na bhai. Zabardasti hai kya? Yeah? Now you would ask, okay, so Amrit, reading 10 pages, you meant to say I should spend 300 rupees only to read 10 pages. No. You would have to buy books today in the hyperly connected world. I've almost 3,000 books at home. उसमें से सिर्फ 50 मैंने खरीदे, रेस्ट ऑल आर बोरोड, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर बोरोड, सम आर स्टोलन, आई कैन, सो देयर आर फैंटास्टिक टूल्स अराउंड अस, या, यू नो, व्हाट्सएप पे एक नया फीचर आया स्टेटस करके, नो वेर वी कैन पुट द मैसेज विच कैन बी सीन बाय एवरीबॉडी ऑन आवर व्हाट्सएप कॉन्टैक्ट्स फॉर 24 आवर्स, व्हेनेवर आई डेस्परेटली वांट अ बुक विच आई डोंट हैव, I'll just put a message on my WhatsApp status. I'm looking for Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari. Does anybody have it? Can you please lend it to me? Within 1 week, I promise, the book will be in your hands. Wo book yahi kahin rehta hai, hamare area mein. But we don't understand the power of these tools. Internet. Ghar pe batata vada banega to usko photo dalenge. Facebook pe. Yeah? Instagram pe. Yeah? See, tool is a tool, right? Our intention matters a lot. मतलब एक चाकू, एक सर्जन के हाथ में तो और एक डाकू के हाथ में तो. See, the tool is the same, but one person takes life, the other person saves life. Intention is everything. So, habit number one, don't take reading too seriously. It's okay to leave books half read. Yeah, कोई पाप नहीं कर रहे हो आप. Habit number two. How many of you say that I don't get time to read books? Yeah? Nobody is busy in life. It's all about priorities. If you have time for Facebook, you have time for a book. Yeah? If you're really busy in life, then Facebook would have been a big flop. Isn't it? Uh-huh. So, before discussing habit number two, let me give a background, a warm-up to you. If you keep doing the same things that you have been doing till now, you will get the same results that you got till now. Yes or no? Yeah? If you want something that you never got, you have to do something that you never did, is what Brian Tracy says in his book, Million Dollar Habits. One of my favorite books, Million Dollar Habits. I would highly recommend it. So expecting extraordinary results without making any change in our daily routine is a fool's game. Yeah? And so when reading became my top priority, suddenly I started finding a lot of value in small, tiny pockets of time during the day. Now, what do I mean by time pockets? So the name of habit number two is fill in the time pockets. What do I mean by time pockets? These are like time pockets of 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 8 minutes, which we mindlessly waste like a street dog wandering on the streets. Yeah, sorry to use this language. I know nobody will admit it. So let me set aside my own ego and admit that yes, I've wasted millions of such time pockets. For example, I'm standing at the railway station to buy a ticket before the lockdown. And there is a long queue. So I'll just stand like a zombie looking at a dandruff of the person standing next to me and just waste those 10 minutes. Yeah, I can see those honest smiles. I know I'm taking the blame on me, but you know, we all are sailing in the same boat. But now I'll just take out a book and read couple of pages. That's all. These are the time pockets I'm talking about. Yeah. The internet goes off in my house very often. I used to get frustrated. But now whenever my life is thrown in offline mode, it is an opportunity for me to read a book. Yeah. I have to visit my dentist thanks to my bad eating habits in the childhood. Every 6 months, I visit my dentist. There are 2-3 patients waiting before me. Instead of looking at their sad faces and having the anxiety of to drill, I just take out a book and read 2-3 pages. This is what I'm talking about. You don't have to take out any time from your schedule separately. You don't have to sacrifice your cooking time. You don't have to sacrifice your kids' time, your fitness time. No, this is what you have to do. Yeah, only 2-3 pages at a time. That's all. And you have to carry your book everywhere you want. Now you might ask, Amrut, it is not practically possible to carry a book every day. Okay. I'm not talking about physical book. Yeah. Thanks to the disruptive nature of internet, the gamut of reading has expanded. Okay. Book in hand style of reading is not the only way of reading nowadays. As one of the gentlemen rightly said, you know, listening to podcast, reading PDF, Kindle, listening to my book summaries on booklet app, they all are part of reading. Yeah. Just book in hand style of reading, aram kursi pe baithna. You can't insist on these 10-year kids and 14-year kids, because if we are technology migrants, they are technology native. They are born with a gadget from the mother's womb. So, yeah. So, fill in the time pockets. Very important habit. And it is one of my favorite habits. I remember, I've read at so many different places. Yeah, at the airport, waiting for the flight, majboori hai humko ek ghanta pehle pahunchna padta hai, right? And then just looking at the attractive people around us, I now just put my nose inside and read a book. Yeah, because I remember, interestingly, most of my bookmarks are those boarding passes of the flights. Yeah, by the way, so when I started taking the total of all these time pockets of mine and my friends and took an average, it came to 60 to 90 minutes per day. Can you believe? You just waste mindlessly 60 to 90 minutes. You know, I give you this exercise for next 1 week and you can try it out. And by the way, so if you just fill up 50% of these time pockets, you can easily read a book of 200 pages in 1 week's time. See, aur ye main sirf reading ke liye nahi bol raha, any good habit. I'm just specifying it to reading because the book is on reading. Any good habit can be filled up in these time pockets. By the way, I have not even considered the commuting time between office and house. Ola, Uber, bus, train. I have not considered it. And I have also not considered the time that we devote to our favorite family member. Can you guess? TV. Yeah. I have thrown my TV 4 years ago. And it won't be an overstatement to say that I devote 70% of my success to this act of kindness of throwing TV out of my house 4 years ago. Seriously. Abhi sirf wooden frame bacha hai TV ka aur abhi uska bookshelf ban gaya. Yeah. I always say to my friends that I find TV very educative. Whenever somebody switches on the TV, I go to the other room and read a book. So that's how TV has helped me. Okay. So let's move on to habit number three. Habit number three is very important for this group of people because I noticed that many of you are reading one particular genre of books. And name of my habit number three is read random. Read random, very important habit. See, we so-called highly educated people, you know, we like everything methodical, that's everything logical. But creativity ko logic pasand nahi hai. Yeah, in randomness, there is innovation chupa hua hai. No, creativity comes from randomness. I'll give some example. So 10-15 years ago, somebody came out with an idea of putting a camera in a mobile. Two random things. Abhi toh looking back, it is very easy to find out logic. But just imagine, go back 15 years ago, somebody came out with this idea. You know, he was sacked for this stupid idea. Can you believe this? Because they just thought it's a random thing. Why will people put a camera, use a camera in a mobile? There is a dedicated device for taking photos. Yeah. And look, the reality is we take more selfies than calling today. Yeah. So when you bring two unassociated things together and try to find patterns and combinations in those completely disparate things, you know, creativity and innovation happens. And hence it is very important to read random books. Random, literally. I might read Harry Potter and Chanakya Niti at the same time. You know, and our brain is very good at finding patterns even in randomness. But we stop it as we get older. You know, you watch kids. Kuch bhi karte, kisi ko kuch bhi laga ke, you know, they enjoy. Yeah. You see all the innovative products around you, they're always a combination of two random things. Let me extend that example of mobile and camera. Now this is a completely wild idea that comes to my mind right now. How about putting a camera in a fridge? Sounds stupid? Yeah. Now let's dig deeper into it. Now, juvenile diabetes is very common nowadays, and child obesity is a serious problem. 13-14 saal ke bachcho ko diabetes hone laga hai, and they are overweight. How about putting a camera in a fridge so that whenever the kid opens the door of the fridge, it will click pictures and send videos to his parents sitting in office so that they can keep a check on his eating habit. Now, does it make sense? See, it's a million-dollar idea. Le lo, kisi ko lena hai. You never know, you will see such kind of fridge in the market very soon. Right? So see, randomness. Abhi ek minute mein million-dollar idea aa gaya. So always read random. And whenever I say read random has a second meaning also. Read across random platforms. Don't stick. Now, as I said, internet ne sab kuch badal diya hai. Yeah? But of course, there are some advantages and disadvantages of reading online, right? So whenever I read an online article or a blog post or somebody on the internet, you know, suddenly those ads pop up, yeah? And then you feel like clicking on that ad, or there's a hyperlink, then you feel like clicking and it will take you to the next web page, a new web page opens. And then suddenly it will ask for your email ID so that you get a free ebook. Yeah. And then you are tempted to give your email ID. Aisa bolte bolte, within 5 minutes, there are 10 tabs open on my internet browser. How many of you have experienced this? I'm very keen to know. Yeah. Just raise your hand. Yeah. Now the problem with online reading is that the very revenue structure of theirs is dependent on shallow reading. On distracted reading. Online reading is not made for focused deep reading. They want us to get distracted every other minute. Now that is the problem, right? Reading has to be focused. So a simple solution is copy the text, put it in my Word document, switch off the Wi-Fi of my laptop and read. Simple solution. Or you can find any other app which will do that for you. Yeah. But not all e-reading is online reading. Yeah, reading on PDF or Kindle, they all are far from these distractions. Yeah. Yeah. So read random means has two meanings. Read all types of genres. Don't fall in love with a particular category of books. Yeah, I read only fiction. I read only Harry Potter. I read only business books. Somebody said right now in the introduction. Yeah, even I made this mistake. When I was in stock market, I used to read only books on stock market. I have read 300 books on stock market. हमको लगता है जो हम जिसमें है टेक्निकल बुक्स ही पढ़ने चाहिए नो ऑलवेज रीड रैंडम एंड द बेस्ट वे